Hello and welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I am Zechariah 1688, and what we're here today with is another episode of The Long Dark. It is a Monday, after all. Now, I am recording this tacked on. The audio you're hearing, my voice, is tacked on after the video, because I don't know for what inexplicable reason, Shadowplay decided not to record my voice, and then Shadowplay promptly crashed. Towards the end of this recording, you'll see how frustrated that can be, frustrating that can be here in just a few. But we are finally leaving Coastal Highway. This is up by that lookout point up at the top of Coastal Highway. We're finally leaving Coastal Highway here. We just gathered some supplies. I'm gonna go check out the lookout tower before we leave. For the most part, the trip was completely uneventful. This is probably going to be a shorter episode too, by the way. The trip was completely uneventful all day. The entire time to get there. It took just about a solid day. Went through the coal mine. The coal mine was fun. We're going to have to go back into the coal mine to get more supplies eventually. I know it. Just because there was so much stuff in that coal mine. Pleasant Valley has greeted me warmly. And with, it's pleasant, sure. It's a valley, definitely. But we'll see, anyway, a lot of good stuff, as you can see in here. I'm not going to describe exactly what's going on step by step of this, the frame here. Just for the simple fact that you can watch it. there will be, probably about a week's worth of video I have to go through and see if it's all a month's worth of video that I have to go through and see if it's all like this. I'm glad I reviewed this before I just uploaded it and sent it up there, otherwise this would be a really weird long dark video. Oh hey, another whetstone. Oh yeah, that's something I describe whenever I get the whetstone. I wore out a rifle cleaning kit and a whetstone and a whole bunch of other things just to finish making everything nice and well worn, well repaired, decent quality, everything as much as I could before we left, because I wanted to carry as little on me as we could, because I knew I was going to be carrying a lot with me anyway. We have the wolf cloak and we have deerskin boots right now, which was amazing. I hibernated for about 2 weeks for everything to cure and to take time to make everything. It was a pain to get all that going, but we finally got it. It was great. I enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun. It felt like an accomplishment to get all that ready and going. So we're marching along. My plan is to get us to Pleasant Valley in this episode and get us hopefully close to the barn, the farm that is in Pleasant Valley. Not the barn per se, but the farmhouse for sure. Spoilers, I don't make it. I'm not dead though. But yeah, so just go ahead and skip right here. Now, here we go. Now, as you can see, I just turned off my lamp. We're trudging along very slowly because we are so weighed down by everything we picked up out of the mine. I should not have picked up all that stuff out of the mine. But I'm thinking, like, whenever we went to Desolation Point, probably not going to come back here again, because I figured we would live at Desolation Point for a while, right? And my phone goes off. I think my phone actually went off about here, too, in the video. I was kind of upset. I need to remember to turn that off. But I'm starting to tear everything down, trying to consolidate, trying to make things lighter for myself, because I don't know what I'm expecting on the other side here. Just kind of getting everything ready. We picked up a whole bunch of ammo out of here. We picked up some whole bunch of food and a little bit of water, actually. I was surprised. I was happy because we were running low on all of that, because I actually got lost in these mines because there's a whole bunch of twists and turns. It took me a little while to get through here, I may have been in here longer than a day, because actually I do remember sleeping in the mines, I just don't remember for how long. Let's see. A little bit tired, as you can see. Yeah. All right. I think, yeah, we got everything. All right, let's go. Let's get out of here. Oh, yeah. Have gun, will travel. Always remember about that. And here we are, finally. Pleasant Valley. What an amazing place, right? Beautiful. Look at it. Just, oh, that is gorgeous view, isn't it? Really is. It's a pretty view. See, I didn't see that wolf down the bottom right. Didn't see him at all when I first was, was kicking around. But don't worry, he's not our problem. We are easily able to avoid him. I didn't even see the wolf until after I was already, like, going past him. And then I heard the crunch of the snow. But what I was pointing at there with the rifle is there's usually a little collection of buildings down there by that bridge. I do believe it's called Rural Crossroads or something like that. But anyway, I know there's at least one, there should be at least one livable home down there, and I figure we can get there for the night, camp there, rest there, and then the next day we can go on to the farm. And so that's my plan as I'm going through this. And you see I've got the flare out, just in case we run across anything. Again, I haven't seen the wolf. I don't know about the wolf. We never end up using the flare, thank goodness. But, yeah. This is fun. Just trudging along here. It started getting really windy about right in here. Really, really windy. And so I'm starting to zigzag down this mountain, and the wind's pushing me a little bit, and it's just, oh. It was a lot more tense than putting voiceover afterwards sounds. Oh man, a lot more tense. But yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and fast forward a little bit right here, I think. And here we are, down here in this little village. Most of the homes are burnt out, as you can see. There's one right in front, and then one a little bit off to the left there. Part of the lost footage is there are two more on the other side of the bridge, but neither one of those are livable. The only one livable is that one that's off screen now to the left on this side of the bridge. But we're going to go check out the shack first. Going to go see if there's anything good for us in there. I'm ending the episode off pretty close, like right after we get in here, and I was going to cut and start a new episode. Lo and behold, Shadowplay disagreed. Shadowplay never even ended the recording here, just kept going for the next little bit, not too much longer. And oh joy, was that fun. So here I am ending the episode off, and then it should be right about here? Yeah, there you go. See, it told me it was starting a new recording and everything. Yeah. Nope, this is all part of the same video. Anyway, so I'm just kind of going along, moseying along. I was like, ooh, hey, this is a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I'm completely weighed down. I should not be picking any of this up at all. I know that now. Hindsight's always 20/20. I knew that then, too, to be fair. I knew it when I was doing it. I should not be picking any of this up. But I was like, you know, I don't know if I'm going to be back here anytime soon. I want to just go ahead and scavenge everything I can out of this house. That way I don't have to worry about coming back. And I'm just like, screw it, we'll come back for that. I was a little bit exhausted. This trip took a lot out of me. Physically, like, in the real world, which is surprising for a game like this. And I'm like, okay, I think we got everything. We're just about done. Oh, wait, yep. Cannot forget the rifle rounds. Always need rifle rounds. Alright, here we go. Let's get back out here and go to the house across the street. And... shit. You gotta be kidding me. And then the video cuts. Right there. And then we're left with this. So, I will catch everyone up in the next episode, which should be next week, of what happened to me. I hope you all enjoyed this. I did get attacked. I barely lived. I had 5% health, and I was bleeding out when we got into the other house. I'll try to do something to make up for losing all the footage. I don't know what I can do. But we live, we barely live, and we got snowed into a blizzard. And the bear ended up dying, thank goodness. So we got something out of this. Something.